I'm Kyle Marsh from the Identity and Network Access Group here at Microsoft, and this video talks about continuous access evaluation in your client applications. When we do token-based authorization, what happens is your client API, your application, makes a call to something like Microsoft Graph and provides it with a token. Now, Microsoft Graph or any API doesn't actually have to call back to Azure AD in order to check the validity of that token. It just needs to check the structure of the JSON web token, is it properly signed, and so forth. And it only needs to go and get the keys we use to sign these tokens about every 12 hours or so. So it's quite efficient, and you don't need the resource is not continuously calling back to the identity provider to check for, if the token is valid. Now, one thing that does come out of this architecture is the token is valid until it expires. And therefore, we at Microsoft Identity have to balance the length of time we issue a token because it will be valid for that whole length of time. So one option to have changed this would have been something called token introspection, where every time a call is made to an API that's protected with Azure AD, that API has to go back and talk to Azure AD to find out what the token is and if it's valid and so on. That's actually a very expensive proposition. It means that all of the calls that you make to your APIs might involve a second call back to us, and that would obviously impact performance as well as just being a generally expensive operation all around. So that's not an optimum solution. Instead, we've been looking at the work that the Shared Signals and Events team and OpenID Connect working group has done. And we've said, well, we could certainly do some initial implementations along those lines, and have implemented the ability for us to listen to events in our resources. So what happens here is something like the Microsoft Graph API actually sets up a listener so that it will get events directly from Azure AD whenever there's an incident or a security type event for a user who we've issued a token for. So this sets up this listener long before even the application that is going to call our API might even be in existence. Now, when the application does arrive and makes that call, say to Microsoft Graph, we can look at the token and the user and say, oh, look, we got an event back from Azure AD a little while ago that says tokens issued before a particular date or time, let's say tokens issued before 1 o'clock in the afternoon, should not be accepted. And since this token was issued at 12:30 in the afternoon, we're going to head and reject or return an unauthorized error to the calling application now. So in addition to returning just the straightforward 401 unauthorized, the Microsoft Graph API or the API will also return an additional set of information in the www-authenticate token that goes back to the calling application. This header will tell the application, first off, that authorization is done through Azure Active Directory, that there is an error, and the specific error here is insufficient claims, and there will be a claims parameter, which when we decode might be something like this, where we're saying your claims are insufficient because the access token has to have a not before, so the moment this token becomes valid, can't be before a particular time. So perhaps we're not going to accept a token before 1 p.m., and the token you gave us is good for 12:30. It was issued at not before time of 12:30. So now the application would go back, ask for a new token saying, I got this claims challenge from Microsoft Graph. Please give me a token that would meet this claims challenge. And then Microsoft Identity can do whatever it needs to do to make sure it's issuing the right token back as appropriate. So the things that can trigger these kinds of events are things like the user being disabled or deleted. Maybe they need an MFA they didn't have before. Maybe their password changed. Maybe even Microsoft Identity Protection has now identified that this user has moved into a high-risk category. The easiest case, of course, is simply you've lost your devices, you go to your administrator, and they explicitly revoke the sessions for your devices. Now, The resource API, Microsoft Graph here, can also participate because we can tell the resource that, hey, there's a conditional access policy for this user. So they're only supposed to access this resource in particular network addresses. Perhaps they're only supposed to access this resource when they're on their corporate network. Now, since the API is being called more often than token refresh is, when the API call gets made, it can notice the IP address has changed and reevaluate whether the conditional access policy is still correct or it needs to be triggered and have the user take corrective action. So there's a couple of ways that we can participate there. Now let's take a look at how this might work. Here on my demo machine, you see I have an application that does not support continuous access evaluation, and it was issued a token for about an hour. We issue our tokens anywhere from 60 to 90 minutes, so about an hour or so from when this application was launched. Obviously, you'd always look at this token response here to find out how exactly long a token is good for, and in this case, it's good for, as we can see, that the clock on the machine says it's 3:15. The clock, this token is good to 4:30. Great, I can go ahead and call the user profile all I want until 4:30. Now, let's go over to our tenant admin, and I will sign in as my tenant admin now, and go to this user's profile page, or this user's page in the Azure portal, and I'm going to explicitly revoke their sessions. So now the signal is going to be sent out to our resources and say, this user, we need to, the sessions are revoked. The token has to be later than 3:15. So the token I got earlier will no longer be applicable. Now what I do need to build into my application is I will need to put in some code. So for example here, when I actually handle a request. So here, I can, if I built on something like the Microsoft Graph SDK, this would already be handled for me in the SDK. If I'm using my own way of calling a REST API, I can go ahead and do some code something like this. I don't need to worry about a successful code, but if I do get a 401 unauthorized return, I need to check for that www-authenticate header. If it's there, I need to make sure it has an error of insufficient claims, and that it also has the claims parameter present as well. If all of those conditions are correct, I can go ahead and grab that claims challenge and then decode it, and then use MSOL to go back to Azure Active Directory and go through my standard acquire token silent, acquire token interactive pattern. I start with acquire token silent, and I say, with these claims, meaning it must meet this claims challenge. If that fails, which it probably will, the user probably has to authenticate again. If that's the case, then I'll fall back to acquire token interactive, again, providing that claims challenge. So I need this code to make sure my application doesn't keep sending a token that's not going to work simply because the application says, well, it's still valid in its lifespan, I can keep sending it. So your application needs to be aware to avoid that. And if it is, then when you instantiate your MSOL client, you can simply say, I have these client capabilities, CP1 designating that your application does in fact support continuous access evaluation. So it's been a while. Let's go back to our application that doesn't support continuous access evaluation and see that it can in fact still work fine. Let's bring up my mobile device, because one of the partners who has enabled continuous access evaluation so far are the folks from Apple. And notice, as soon as I went to go to get to Moses' mail, immediately it says I have to go and enter the password again. That's because continuous access evaluation kicked in on my mobile device here in my Apple Mail application, and it immediately is no longer making it possible for me to get new mail from my server until I correct that situation. So there you can see continuous access evaluation is helping to protect the mail for Moses here on his mobile devices. So I would encourage all of your applications that call Microsoft Graph to adopt continuous access evaluation. It makes your application more secure. It also makes your application more resilient. When we issue a token to a continuous access evaluation aware application, that token is issued for up to 24 hours or up to 28 hours. And oftentimes we can tell MSOL to proactively refresh that token in, say, 12 hours. That means there's always a 12-hour buffer during which token acquisition could fail and your application would not notice. As long as it happens within that 12-hour buffer, no matter what interrupted that flow of tokens, as long as it's less than 12 hours, your application would see no impact. So if you're using the Microsoft Graph SDK, this is very easy. Most capability is built in. If you're not, make sure you are checking for claims challenges when you call an Azure AD protected resource, like the Microsoft Graph APIs. And if you are given a claims challenge, go and reacquire the tokens back with that claims challenge. So it's really great if you make your applications ready for continuous access evaluation. Thank you very much, and enjoy the rest of your day.